Welcome back to Come and See Christianity. This is lesson number 41, Equipping the Saints. Equipping the Saints. Now, if you've been with us, you know that in section one, we began with a look at God's divine design. We followed that up in section two with a look at the three divisions, the head, the heart, and the hands, noting that every human being needs God's truth, God's love, and the fruit that validates faithful obedience into and amongst the family of God. In section three, we looked at the five different types of disciples, noting that every human being is accounted for in Christianity's way of looking at the world. You are either a lost person, a lover, a learner, a leader, or a lifer. And that can be a fluid process. Praise God, not everyone who starts off lost will end there. Sadly, however, according to God's word, most will. Hence the sense of urgency to come and see Christ and Christianity. In section four, we looked at the seven details or the fundamentals of the faith that give explanation to the core essentials of the Christian biblical worldview. In section five, we moved on to the heart exercises that are known as the disciplines for the loving heart. In section six, where we are and where we'll finish, we look at the 24 distinctives that offer up a portrait of the living and the loving family of God. 24 perspectives on what it is to be the family of God. In this lesson, number 41 out of a total of 52, we look at equipping the saints. And our lesson will focus on what it means to equip. And then after defining true biblical equipping, we'll see it in action amongst the authentic family of God. Who are the saints? Is it a matter of just preparing people in church? Or is there a difference to equipping the family of God that is in Christ? I pray you'll see there is an eternal difference. And that's why it's so important. It's in part why we are committed in showing the world Christ and Christianity. We're dedicated to equipping the saints, to equip the saints, to equip the saints. Amen and amen.